YouTubers, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Today is January 10th, 2023. USGS said there was a magnitude 3.2 earthquake, and no, it was a 3.6. And they said it was close to Porterville, California, and I don't think it was. 47 people have sent in reports to USGS saying they felt it. They gave it an intensity level of 3. It was felt as far as Los Banos. Yeah. And let's zoom in here. Now, I downloaded. I was working on the Long Valley Caldera. And I had downloaded a monitor from that area. Let me show you. This monitor here on the left is from Mammoth Mountain there at the Long Valley Caldera. This one here is from Slate Mountain, supposedly close to where the earthquake occurred. I'll show you the seismic signature. There was actually a small popping that grew into a larger one. And we'll go to the seismic signature here. Going to Google Earth, here's the location of that magnitude 3.5. And here we have Porterville on the left. And this here is the monitor for Slate Mountain. Right there. That's the one I downloaded. Now the other one, let me show you. Okay, let's go up over there to where the other Mammoth Mountain is. It'll take me there first and I'll show you that earthquake monitor that I'm using right here. I believe this is, Mammoth Lakes. And it's at the Mammoth Lakes community. I think the monitor is inside the police station there at Mammoth Lakes. Yeah, this is probably what they call a long period earthquake. Let me go to the Hertz. See, it's up above 10 Hertz. And I was also looking into long period earthquakes. Now, they said that this earthquake is about 10 miles below sea level, which would go along with long period earthquakes, which would be either volcanic or tectonic. Long period earthquakes typically occur at greater depths between 10 and 35 kilometers. Let me bring it over. Or 6 to 22 miles. Volcanic earthquakes, volcanic tremor events are often located near or below what's called the brittle ductal transition. I've talked about that. They're usually about 3 miles, which is the area where the crust stops behaving in a brittle manner, fracturing, and starts to flow like silly putty. I was looking into this because I had a paper that was sent to me about seismic monitoring and activity increase at California Caldera. This is about the Long Valley Caldera. And that earthquake swarm that they had in the 90s, late 90s, I believe it was. I've done 2 reports about that. Like I said, they're saying it's a 3.2. It came from the California Integrated Seismic Network, Southern California Seismic Network, Caltech. Let me bring this over. USGS Pasadena and Partners. Okay, we'll go back. I'm going to show you the moment tensor ball. Right there, you can see that the fault moved going northwest a little bit, supposedly. All right, so here's the monitor for Mammoth Lakes, and I'll bring it down. And I'll show you, it comes in as a 3.60. And let me bring it back up. I ended it right there. I'll have to make that bigger. Let me go to the spectrogram first. Yeah, that's where I ended it. Okay, and let's go to the seismic signature. Oops, wrong one. Okay. Yeah, ended it right there. Now, yeah, let's pull it over a little bit. Let me make that bigger. And then let's go to the Hertz. Okay, around the 10 Hertz, 10 to 1 Hertz. You can see that there. Okay. Yeah, and look how large it came in. Let me go back to the spectrogram for Mammoth Lakes. Compared to Slate Mountain, which is supposed to be right next to where the earthquake occurred. Let's go to the seismic signature and we'll pull that. See? Yeah. Yeah, these are long period earthquakes. Yeah, it could either be the plate moving, the fault moving. Yeah, and then afterwards, let's look at that. Yeah. Now, again, this is by Slate Mountain. And we'll go to the same time frame. Let me close this out. Yeah, because see, I pulled Mammoth first. Okay, what time was that? Okay, 1605, 1606. Oops, went off the line. 1604, 1605. Okay, this is Mammoth over here on the left. And this here is Porterville, Slate Mountain on the right. Here we have on the left, which would be Mammoth Mountain area, Mammoth Lakes, the city, at 940. Here we have Slate Mountain. I wanted to see, because here we got the thickening of the lines at Mammoth Lakes. And I wanted to see what was going on there at Porterville. Yeah, let me make that one bigger. Yeah, look at that. And let's go to the seismic signature. Yeah, okay. I don't know. I only pulled 3 different time frames, 8 hours each for Potter Valley. Or Porterville, excuse me, Porterville. Yeah, why did it show up so much larger at Mammoth Lakes? There's another small earthquake over here. 1151. Let's see if they reported it. No, they did not. And that one comes in as a magnitude 2.09. Okay. Yeah, let's look at the seismic signature again. And I'll pull it over so you can see where I ended it right there. I guess I could end it there. We'll go there and there. And then it would have been a 1.90, but yeah. Okay. Let's close this. And there was, yeah, some other activity. Look at this. I have not had a chance to look to see what was happening globally yet for large earthquakes during this time. Okay, let's go to the spectrogram. You can see how wide these signatures were. Hot gases, magma was coming up. Yeah, and the this is harmonic tremors. And then right there, again, harmonic tremors. And then there was another earthquake right there. It's marked in red, and it's got probably a long P wave on it. More likely not being reported, I would assume. Let's see here. Let's go. Probably right there. Okay. Yeah, 2.88. Okay. Let me bring it down for you. 2.88. Again, this is Mammoth Lakes. Okay, we'll come up and see. There was another. Yeah, that's probably globally a large earthquake that happened globally. And they got some little stuff marked in red here. Again, that there is tectonic. And yeah, long period, showing it rattled for a long time. Easy to decipher. Okay, and then let's bring it up to show you what it was showing. during that time. Again, this is Mammoth Lakes. And that's what I was looking into. I haven't done a report about Mammoth Lakes in a while. I thought, well, I don't believe in chance. That when that paper was sent to me. Yeah, look at that. Let me bring it up. Yeah, seismic signature there. Oops. Let me close that because it made it bigger. And let me go back. Okay, we got one there, and then there's another one there. Yeah, it made it bigger. Okay. Anyways, yeah, I thought that was really odd. How many miles is that from where they're saying it occurred? Okay, let's go to the little ruler. We're at kilometers right now. So from there to there is 167. Oops, I didn't. Okay. I tried to get the stick. There. 174 kilometers or 108 miles about. It's probably a little bit farther because see, my little line just doesn't go quite to that earthquake station. Yeah. So, yeah, I'd like to know what you guys think about that. Yeah, why would it show up so much better, larger, at Mammoth than it does there at Slate Mountain? Okay, we'll go to the spectrogram. Even this stuff. It's larger at Mammoth. Anyways, yeah, put your thoughts down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared for a disaster. As you have seen with recent events, they don't have enough emergency people to come and rescue you. Have food, water, medicine. Don't forget the pets. For, at least 3 weeks. You know what I heard about China? China has stored up enough wheat and sugar and copper and oil. I believe it's copper. China has now stockpiled 70% of the world's resources. 70%. Wheat and sugar. They have stockpiled 50% of the world's resources. And China only has about 20% of the world's population. Yeah, China's got a lot, but globally, percentage-wise, they only have about 20% of the world's population. So why are they stockpiling, probably for several years of food? The prepper community is saying you probably should have at least a year. Now maybe 2 years of food and water and medical supplies. So what are your thoughts? The talk is China's prepping for war. Be prepared. Thank you very much for watching. Please share my videos. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Make sure you're still subscribed. At the end of every month, YouTube loves to unsubscribe people. So at the end of December, a lot of people will probably unsubscribe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.